Hello, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. For today's video, I wanted to do a spin on an older tutorial. The older one was with Dutch braids. This one is with French braids. So if you've seen that one and are now watching this one, comment down below which braid you like better, Dutch versus French. If you're new to my channel, make sure to like and subscribe. If you're already subscribed, thank you so much. Click that bell so you never miss any future videos. And let's get started. To start the first half up style, I'm going to begin by parting my hair near the center. And then I'm going to pick up a section on the left side of the part for my braid. I'm creating a French braid, so I'm going to divide the section into three smaller pieces. And I'm going to cross the back strand over the middle, then cross the front strand over the middle. Then I'm crossing the back strand over the middle, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it over the middle strand as well. Now I'm crossing the front strand over the middle and incorporating a new section of hair from along the hairline. And I'm going to repeat this pattern, continuing the French braid on this left side of my head. I'm going to alternate between crossing each side strand over the middle strand, while also bringing in new sections of hair into the braid as well. So I'm crossing one side over the middle, picking up a new section and bringing it into the braid. Then I'm crossing the other side over the middle, picking up a new section and crossing it over the middle strand as well. And I'm going to repeat this pattern, continuing the braid along the left side of my head until I've brought in hair from the top of my head and from above my left ear. And once the braid reaches this point, I'm going to stop adding in additional pieces and just continue braiding the section down to the ends in a regular three-strand braid. Then I'm going to slide a couple bobby pins over the bottom so it doesn't unravel. Now I'm going to create another French braid on the right side of my head. So I'm repeating the same process as before, and I'm going to divide out a few pieces of hair to leave out around my face. Then I'm picking up a section next to the part line, and I'm going to divide this into three smaller sections. I'm crossing the side strands over the middle strand, and after the initial stitch of the braid, I'm going to begin incorporating new sections of hair into the braid. So I'm creating the braid along the right side of my head, similar to the left braid, bringing in hair from both the top of my head, along the part line, and from along the hairline as well. Once the braid reaches the top of my right ear, I'm going to stop incorporating new pieces into the bottom side of the braid, but continue adding in sections from the top of my head. Once the braid reaches the left braid on the opposite side, I'm going to stop braiding the section and now go back over it, pulling on the bottom of the braid so it's wider and looks softer. And now I'm going to fold both braids under themselves at the back of my head, and then I'm going to pin them in place with bobby pins. And I just like to hook a bit of hair from the braids and then push the pins in so they follow the braid, and this will hide them underneath the hair. And once the braids are pinned in place, then I can remove any extra pins and unravel the bottoms of the braids. For the second hairstyle, I'm going to begin by dividing my hair into two sections, a left side and a right side. I'm going to create a zigzag part line down the center of the back of my head, and this will just make hiding that part line a little bit easier. So once I've divided my hair into two sections, I'm going to tie off the right side to start with the left. So I'm going to divide out a few small pieces to frame my face and then pick up a section on the left side of the part for the braid. I'm creating a French braid again, so I'm crossing the side strands over the middle strand. Then I'm going to begin incorporating new sections into the braid. So I'm crossing the other side over the middle, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it over the middle strand as well. And I'm going to repeat this pattern, crossing the side strands over the middle strand while also bringing in new sections of hair and incorporating them into the braid. And I'm going to continue the braid down this side of my head. So I'm alternating between crossing each side strand over the middle strand while also incorporating new sections of hair into the braid. And I'm going to repeat this pattern, continuing the braid along this side of my head. And I'm bringing in new sections from both the hairline and from along the part line that is going down the center of the back of my head. Once the braid reaches the nape of my neck, I'm going to combine it all together and then tie it off using a clear elastic band. Now I'm going to repeat the exact same steps with the hair on the right side of my head. So I'm dividing off a section near the part line and dividing it into three smaller pieces. And I'm going to cross the side strands over the middle strand. And then I'm going to begin incorporating new sections of hair into the braid. So I'm crossing one side over the middle, picking up a new section of hair and bringing it into the braid. Then I'm crossing the other side strand over the middle, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it over the middle strand, bringing it into the braid as well. And I'm just going to repeat this process, continuing the braid along this side of my head. I'm alternating between crossing the side strands over the middle strand while bringing in new sections of hair from both the part line at the back of my head and the hairline until all of the hair is brought into the braid, or at least until the braid reaches the nape of my neck. And then I'm going to combine all of the hair together and tie it off using a clear elastic band. I'm going to combine both of the previously two ponytails together and tie them off using a clear elastic band. And now I'm going to wrap the elastic with a small section of hair, and I'm going to use a topsy tail tool to attach it. So I'm sliding the tail of the tool through the middle of the ponytail, or just under the elastic really. Then I'm going to wrap the piece of hair around the elastic band until I get to the end of the section. Then I'm going to bring the end through the loop at the top and then pull the tail of the tool down so it slides through the ponytail under the elastic. This will hold the wrapped piece in place so you won't need to use another elastic or a bobby pin to hold it in place. Now I'm going to transition into an updo. I'm going to take the hair elastic and pull it partway down the ponytail to create a small loop in the hair. I'm going to take the ends and I'm going to divide them into two equal sections and then wrap each one over the top of the bun, crossing them at the top, and then wrap them back down so they're underneath the loop. I'm going to take a clear elastic band and tie the two ends together underneath the bun. I think out of all of the styles, this one is my favorite. I just think it's such a cute look with the double braids and the messy bun.
Thank you so much for watching. As always, if you had a favorite, please comment down below. I think the updo was my favorite, either that one or the half-up style. If you're new to my channel, be sure to like and subscribe. Click that notification bell as well. Then you'll be notified every time I post a new video so you will never miss one. And I will see you next time.